What's up, everybody? This is Investing Sensei here to bring you episode 45 of the Webull Option Adventures, where our goal is to sell options and collect that premium. Our long-term goal is to try to get to making about $1,000 a week. We're definitely way far away from that, but I know that eventually we will get there. Currently the portfolio is at $45,024.90. We are down about 23.20%, which comes out to be a total of negative $13,166. We will eventually recover, but we are collecting some crumbs every single week. Those add up over time. But you'll see our cash balance right now is at $1,439.40. And that was as well, you'll see is that our options buying power is $6,976.65. So I actually reached out to Webull support this past week, and your options buying power is actually the way it's calculated is half of your overnight buying power. So if you were to divide $13,953.30 by two, you should get roughly around the 6,000 that you'll see for our options buying power. So that was a very interesting thing that I learned this past week with Webull. So that is how you get your options buying power, in case you guys were wondering. Definitely that was one thing that I was kind of curious about. But if you guys see, I'm going to show you guys the spreadsheet right now on our monthly profits. You'll see that overall for October of 2021, we closed making a total of $626.17 overall. You'll see the previous month of September, we made $516.56. So right now I really like this graph because it's kind of showing me where I'm at with my monthly profits, and I think you know, for November I am gonna try to aim to hopefully make above $626.17. I will try to make right around that, but the goal is to try to make above that. So, you know, hopefully we can continue to grow this, and we'll see this chart going upwards and staying consistent, because our long-term goal is to try to get to $1,000 and premium is what we collect every single week, you know, and I know we'll get there eventually. So we'll see how that works out. I think the graph is something that's going to be very motivating in the long term, and it's also going to keep us on track. So we will see how that plays out, guys. But if we look back at the Webull app, there's a couple trades that I did do this past week. I really didn't actually log in too much this week, so there wasn't much profit that I took, especially because a lot of my positions are tied up for this week. And so the next week that I'm really looking forward to is something that should allow me to put in some more trades. So we'll see how that plays out. But the first one we do have is actually four cash secured puts on SDC, so Smile Direct Club, at a strike price of $4. They will be expiring on the 19th of November, so about 19 more days or so. And this one we did collect 11 cents. So this one should start decaying pretty quickly because we are getting closer to the expiration date. This one that we do have is that I did place these trades closer to earnings date, but Smile Direct Club did end up moving their earnings date 1 week earlier. So the one that I am a little bit that I'll need to watch is the next one that we do have here, which I have 20 cash secured puts at a strike price of $4.50. It's actually going to expire in 2 weeks on the 12th of November, and I did collect $18 per premium, or I guess per contract. It's currently trading about 21, so I am a little bit down on that, but we should start decaying soon. One of the things that, you know, since they will be doing earnings, I believe 2 weeks from now, we could see some volatility, so this could bring up the premium, but we'll see what happens, because the stock has been quite a bit volatile. Last week I could have actually bought back at about maybe 30% is what I was able to purchase it, and I could have re-entered the position. I could have made some small profit, but oh well, I didn't do it. We will see what happens with this one. During earnings I might be able to exit it early, because you know, about I believe the stock's trading around like $5.15 to a dollar, $5.30 to 40 cents. So it fluctuates right around that, but we'll see what happens with that one. The next one we do have here, guys, is Tattoo Chef. So we have 300 shares, and currently we haven't sold any covered calls because as well, I can't really collect much premium with this one, and it's too risky for me to sell it at a lower strike price. But we'll see what happens because you know, we're going to continue to hold Tattoo Chef. Hopefully I can sell some more cash secure puts, bring down my cost basis, and you know, long term I do believe Tattoo Chef is going to grow massively. So this is actually one of my stocks that I do have in my long term growth portfolio, so it's very exciting to see Tattoo Chef there. I go to Target, see all these awesome you know, frozen foods that they do have, which is pretty exciting. But the next one we do have here, guys, is SoFi. So I'm excited about this one because we do have 200 shares. I actually sold two covered calls, and at a strike price of $18.50. It'll actually be expiring next week on the 5th of November. I collected about $1.10, and this one actually started moving upwards, and I had to roll the call, and so I had to roll it out for like a month. So finally it's about to expire, and I think we're going to get our shares taken away because SoFi is trading at $20.14, and then our strike price of SoFi is $18.50. So we're going to at least get our shares taken away. We're going to make the difference between our cost basis and the strike price. We will lose out on the any appreciation above the strike price, so that kind of sucks there, but we will get the capital back, and we will be able to put some more trades. So that is very exciting there, and I've been waiting for that one as well. The next one that we do have here is Mara. So we have 200 shares of Mara at a strike price. I sold two covered calls at a strike price of $50, and it's actually gonna expire the 12th of November, which is 2 weeks from now, and we collected $1.84 per contract, and we should see most likely that this 200 shares get taken away because currently the stock is trading at $51.95. strike price right now is $50, so we will see what happens in those 2 weeks. But I'm very excited because this one as well, I did have to roll it for almost a month, so we will see this collateral, or I'll at least be able to sell some more covered calls once they expire. If they expire worthless, that's fine with me. We will continue to hold them and sell covered calls. The next one here, guys, that we do have, this is the one that I have been losing quite a bit of money, but again, you don't lose any money until you do sell the stock. But we do have 100 shares of Beyond Meat, and I actually sold a covered call. I sold it at a strike price of $114. It actually expired yesterday on the 29th, and we collected $7, and then it expired worthless. So Beyond Meat closed at $99, and so definitely nowhere near our strike price of $114. So that one was a pretty good trade. We're going to continue to collect crumbs with Beyond Meat. I have to play it pretty safe because Beyond Meat could just shoot up. It's done it in the past, and I just hate to roll because then I have to roll for like almost close to a month to be able to stay in the positive. So yeah, we're gonna continue to do these small crumbs for Beyond Meat until we recover. If we do get some more available cash, I might actually average down on Beyond Meat, and we will see what happens with that one. The last one here we do have, guys, is 400 shares of Neo. I'm really excited about this one. Neo, we do have, I actually sold four covered calls at a strike price of $47, and they actually expired yesterday on the 29th of October. We collected $5 per contract, so that was about a total of $20 that we made. And then, you know, the contract did expire worthless. Neo closed at $39.36, and strike price was $47. So definitely nowhere near our strike price. And, you know, Neo has been fluctuating between about $38 to about $42 this past week. So it's very exciting. We're going to see Neo start moving upwards, just kind of like SoFi and Mara. The only thing that I'm trying to avoid is getting caught in the position where I have to roll the call. And you know, because once it gets moving, Neo, we are going to make some pretty good money. But you know, we're going to see what happens over the long term. We'll see what happens. But This is all I have for you on the WeWo app. We'll jump into the Google Sheets and I'll show you guys all the trades that we did do. But before we do that, be sure that you're subscribed with that bell notification if you haven't done so as well. Simply hit the like button. That's all I ask in return. It helps the channel up a lot, guys. And let's go ahead and jump over to the Google Sheets so I can show you guys all the trades we did. And then I'll see you guys over there. Alright guys, so we're here at the Google Sheets. I am going to go ahead and show you guys what we made for this week. It wasn't a lot, but we finally wrapped up the month of October. So on the 29th is what we ended up doing. So 29th of October, and we made a puny $26.75. This week I wasn't very active as well. Most of our collateral was tied up. I did have about $6,000, almost $7,000 worth of buying power on the options, but I want to leave that reserved for any red days that we do have, because that would be great, because the premiums there would be amazing for cash cured puts. If we look at the graph again, I will show you guys right here what we ended up making. So $626.17. So if we look at the average over the past 3 months, you'll see we're starting to like consolidate and start getting consistent with our profit. So we're making right around $500 to $600. And then, long-term goal is to try to get this to 700, then 800, then 900, then 1000 for the month, which 1000, that would be pretty sweet for the month. We would be making some pretty good money there. That would be about $250 every single week. And then, that would be a good long-term goal for that. If we look at the weekly performance, you'll see that if we look for week 74, well, I guess not 74, but 73, that was on 29th, we made $26.75, which brings our total to $59,845.85. This is right here just assuming that we don't sell any of our shares below our cost basis. So that's where that number is, because that is our initial investment plus all the premium we've collected so far. And then if we ended up looking over here, you'll see we've collected a total of $13,426.51 in premium. And then as well, total return so far is about 28.92% that we've collected. If we do account for taxes, which this is a taxable account, that's about 20.25% a return after taxes. So that is pretty good so far, and we are getting better at the options game. So we will see how that plays out over the long term. If we look at the trades, guys, you'll see on the credits, so far we have all these trades that are open. So SoFi, which should be expiring next week, which is very exciting, on the 5th of November. So we'll see how that one plays out. We'll see if our shares get taken away or the contract will expire worthless. I think we will probably get our shares taken away. That's what it seems like, most likely. The next one here is on the 12th of November, which is 2 weeks from now, is Mara's covered calls. That one kind of fluctuates between $49 and $52, so we will see how that one plays out in the next 2 weeks. And then this one is the main one that I am putting a lot of my money on, is the Smile Direct Club, which is the cash secured puts. We are getting very close. We will be in earnings during all of these, which kind of sucks. I hate trying to play these during earnings. This one was a little bit less risky, that's why I went ahead and only sold four. But these are the ones that I ended up selling more towards knowing that it was before earnings, and then earnings turned out to be on the 8th of November. So we will see how that one plays out. As well, I wouldn't mind getting assigned some Smile Direct Club. I think they've been beaten down so much that we should see some positive going forward. Over here we do have Beyond Meat, which we sold a covered call, and you'll see that it expired worthless. And the last ones over here were Neo, which were covered calls as well, and they expired worthless. So that we will be collecting these crumbs, and it'll be exciting seeing what happens next week. Over here on the debit, guys, you will see that we didn't do anything. We didn't buy anything back, and as well for the gains, we didn't do anything as well. And then the current buys, guys, there was nothing there for the current buys as well. So yeah, that's actually wraps up the you know, weekly update for the Webull portfolio this week. We did collect just a little bit of money, not too much, but you know, they are crumbs, they do add up. And overall, $626.17 for the month of October. I'm pretty happy with that. We will see what happens for the month of November, so it'll be really exciting how that plays out. Yeah, guys, this is all I have for you. Be sure that you're subscribed with that bell notification as well. Don't forget to drop a big like on the video so that you help out the channel. That's all I ask in return. And I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. Stay safe out there. Bye, guys.